Video shoot number three, we were up and ready, ready for any challenges at this point. And little did we know, we had another one right ahead of us. I had called up the same taxi driver that took us around for the vibe shoot, and he was down. He was part of our team now. I wanted to be outside for this shoot, to capture some of the plush greens and the true beauty of Oaxaca's rolling mountain ranges. So we drove about an hour and a half outside of town to Hierve el Agua, Spanish for the water boils. Stunning views atop these massive rock formations that resemble cascades of waterfalls hundreds of feet tall. There's typically dozens of tourists there at once, so we were planning to get a few quick shots of me on the side or maybe a corner quickly. It was raining hard on the way in, so we were a bit worried about equipment and not being able to shoot, but we agreed to stick it out in the parking lot, and I'd say about an hour after, we watched everyone scrambling out to their cars. All three of us look at each other knowing this could be perfect. We hurried down there once the rain subsided. Stunning natural infinity pool, a beautiful shade of greenish blue, and limestone was as smooth as silk, outlaying everything. The view was never ending atop this vista. We had it all to ourselves. But the true magic was in the incredible lightning storm that was on display. I had never seen anything like it. And it was silent lightning floating over the mountains every 10, 15 seconds, far off in the distance. So we knew we were safe. The slight rumble of thunder would complete the ambiance. Scotty was quickly scanning for the perfect shots and planning for me to be in certain areas so we could capture this once-in-a-lifetime visual perfectly. I pressed play on the portable Bose player that was lodged inside my belt, so I had some music to perform to. But it was so windy, Scotty couldn't hear and was just capturing the moments of me performing as we changed angles and scenes. And we knew later we could line up the edits and lyrics. That would be the easy part. But all this fluorescent, powerful lightning storm just ripped through the sky over these stunning crests of never-ending mountains. I sang my lyrics as if I was performing for an arena, fully aware we were in the middle of a moment that we'd never be able to capture ever again. I just knew it was a moment we were going to cherish forever. Once the shots were wrapped and darkness began to gradually cover the backdrop, we all just sat there in amazement and watched Mother Nature in all her beauty as the light show continued on. Before we left, I had to take a moment to myself. I went to the side and sat on a ledge and just closed my eyes and meditated and gave a long prayer of gratitude, trying to harness this moment and stay present for every last second. I wished I could have sat on that ledge forever. I opened my eyes and felt a tear streaming down my cheek. So much was running through me. The joy of being back making music, meeting Scotty and knowing he would be so key to bringing these visions to life, and to be sitting here watching this epic storm atop this mountain we had all to ourselves. It was just pure bliss. They were tears of pure joy. The song and video are actually on the next album coming up, but I had to include it here because it was so pivotal in that every single video to follow would be inspired by nature in some way, and it even sparked the idea for me wanting to go to Alaska, which I'll discuss in pieces ahead. Hierve el Agua will forever hold a deep place in my heart. It was one of the most powerful moments of my life, and it truly shifted everything.